All right, guys. So, I've been getting some requests to go over a budget Dragon Link list. Now, I played budget Dragon Link at one regional, did okay. I won't say I did bad, won't say I did great. But so far in testing with Bestial Dragon Link, I really like 43 cards. If you don't like 43 cards, cut some hand traps. These are just generically good hand traps typically, but we're going over to core mostly. The hand traps aren't super relevant. Note that we got announced the other day. I made a post on my community page. I don't really cover Yu-Gi-Oh news. I cover whatever I want, basically. So we are getting a anniversary rarity collection thing that's gonna reprint a bunch of cards, mostly staples. I wish the Bestial Labellion was being reprinted for you guys. I really do. It is getting a quarter century secret rare reprint, but that's not gonna make the secret like any cheaper, unfortunately. I apologize for that. But anyway, the side deck is an in order of upgrade path. And then we're gonna go over to main. I think three safer and three black metal kinda or a mainstay, especially if you're playing budget Dragon Link. Safer and black metal both have commons. If you have more money to throw into it and you don't want to buy some of the other cards that are down there in the side deck, feel free to spend some money on upgrading any of these cards in rarity. These are pretty much your main starters plus Red MD. If you're playing black metal, you have to play this. Now, Safer is worse in budget Dragon Link just because you're not able to add stuff back with Labellion as much or add back big level 8 dragons from your graveyard. But Safer is still really good to get you into your white and black dragon as extenders, so there's that. The black dragons get you Red MD. Red MD is just a pretty decent extender if you open it without these. But typically you don't want to see it, which is another reason why we're at 43 cards. So we have a good chance of seeing our three ofs. And or we have less of a chance of opening our one ofs, and it doesn't hurt our chance to open our three ofs that much. But this is all kind of stock standard. If you play Dragon Link, you know this. There's not a whole bunch to talk about. The Rocket package, you can go pretty heavy on if you want to. I like the two Tracer, one Synchron, one Recharger, and the one Apso Router, even in this. Because in the extra deck I put together for this, we're not doing a whole bunch of rank 10s. Or not rank 10s, level 10 Synchros. You could play the Chen Ying Sword Soul if you want to. It's like a $2 card. You could play that down there too. It's not in the side deck, but figured I'd mention it and play three Tracer and a heavier Bestial count than what I'm on. I like this lineup. I'm not a huge fan of Synchron in general, but it's a decent card, give you a little bit of grind game. The Rockets are Rockets. They're your main extenders. They get you into Savage Dragon. We all know this. If you're new to the deck, this probably isn't the video for you, but is at the same time. But going over to Noctos for additional extenders because we are on a smaller Bestial count than we typically are. I play 11 in Bestial Dragon Link, including Labellion. If we don't, I play 8. So I figured two Nocto would go pretty well to get you some draws and chain block your Striker Dragon. And plus, we have our white and black as additional extenders. I do want to play Nocto and Bestial Dragon Link. The problem is that I play it at one because we don't need to play more of it and we never see it. And also, I can just play non-engine instead, which Bestial Dragon Link kind of struggles with, in my opinion, but not the point. We're not talking about Bestial Dragon Link. We are talking about budget Dragon Link or Dragon Link on a budget, however you want to say it. But I feel you could play three. I like two, just as a generic, just free body extender. White and black, baby Chaos Dragons, you have to play. There's not a whole bunch to talk about. Extenders help you chain block. Pretty good. Levianeer is a common in the Albaz structure deck if you got it along with Safer and the white and black dragons. I do feel like you have to play Levy. Because Levy just helps you pop cards, rip a card out of your opponent's hand. Fairly good card. I love Levianeer. Albaz is part of the budget part. In Bestial Dragon Link, you don't have to play this. You can just play more Link monsters instead. But this just gives you a really good seals target and can put your opponent off guard because nobody really expects this. But moving on into Magnemma. Magnemma, I think, went up recently to like $20 a card. This is the most expensive card in the main deck. But you have to play it. You cannot play Dragon Link and not play Magnemite. You could probably get away with cutting Druis and Sorinir. These are basically just here for extenders, and Druis Worm's decent going second. That's basically it for these. But Magnemite, search a dragon in the end phase, get you follow up. Really solid. You have to play it, in my opinion. I'm sorry for that. The card is, last time I checked, about $20 a piece. If it's cheaper than that, well, buy it still. Regardless of how much it is, I think you have to buy it. If it goes up to like 30 or 40, which I don't see this card doing, probably play something else, maybe, but no. Like, you still have to play Magnemite, in my opinion. Druis and Sorinir are just extenders. This one helps you go second and set up dumb stuff. This card's really good at Branded Beast, but you can't really play Beast and Regain. Well, you can play Regained if you play it at three. But you can't play Beast without Rebellion. Sorinir's other effect is basically irrelevant. It's just an extender for you. Chaos Space is Chaos Space. We love this card. Card's broken. Get you your white and black dragon. Can get you Levy in this deck. This card is a little bit worse because we don't have the Bestial Rebellion and the Emperor Dragon. Three quick launches to go with your rockets and the Boot Sector and the Ravine. To really just go with your rockets. I mean, you can dump Levy if you have a safer engrave to add it back to your hand. That is an interaction you can do with Ravine, but I'm not sure how much will come up. And the hand trap ratio, this is probably how I play it, but you can play it however you want. Moving on to the side, we got one Savage, one Striker. Not going to talk about this. It's standard. Pisty and Rom are also just main standard Dragon Link combo. Two seals, I feel like, is still very important in budget Dragon Link. I think two is standard at minimum now. Quadborn to Lingerous for the Chaos Space combo. Triple Burst because Pisty combo going to Boro in. IP and Unicorn. IP is like $15 now. Savage is also 20. IP, good card. If you have the extender to add it to the board, it's pretty good. This could be a Dark to Dark Charmer as well. Unicorn could be any other link if this card is money, but I don't believe it is. Boro End is Boro End, your boss monster. And then the Branded Fusions, these are all like a dollar. Moving on to the upgrade path, which is the more important part of the video, is what I think you should prioritize. First, you need to get at least two, preferably three copies of the Bestial Rebellion. This is the best extender in the deck because it turns your Bestials on and is just a free body to link with. So, I do believe you need three of this. You can get away with two. I almost topped the regional with one, but I think three is the solid number. Baldrake is a budget card, but if you're playing Rebellion, you need to up your Bestial count and play also three Sorinir. In my opinion, if you're gonna play the 43 card build, and then add a Baldrake to synergize with your Druis, but it's only if you're on Rebellion. Emperor Dragon, you do not need. I do want to say this, but if you have the money and you want to get a card that can get you a little bit of follow up, and it's also an easy card to side out, Emperor Dragon, this card's really good if you can afford it. If you can't afford it, don't worry about it. You don't need it. For your spells, I feel like Triple Tactics Talent in this deck is a must. You don't really, if you're playing budget, you don't really need it. But because this card is $15 and it's not mandatory, in my opinion, to the deck, but I would play it if you can afford it. If you already own it, cool, just throw it in and cut out like freaking Drolls and Nibs or something. I really like Talents. Talents, good card. Beast and Regain, again, synergize with the Rebellion. You could play Regain because you are still banishing a decent bit, but you wouldn't play Beast, and I really, really wouldn't play Ivor unless you have Rebellion. An Access Code and Boral Sword for your Link 4s to help you break boards. Boral Sword is like $2, Access Code is like $30. They're gonna do basically the same thing. But Access Code is better. I sold my Access Code because I'm stupid and I gotta rebuy it now, but play Ivor 1. Like, they're fine. They'll do basically the same thing. Now, Synchro wise, I think priority. Granted, this card is cheap, but if you want to throw it in down here, you can. Like maybe cut the Unicorn or the IP and play a Scarlight for time. It'd be okay. Baron is getting a reprint. I think multiple reprints in the same set, but don't quote me on that. I don't know how that set works. Baron is getting another reprint. The price of this card will go down. So, if you can afford it, get it. It's pretty easy to make with Tracer and Bestials. Just buy it. Okay? If it's cheap. This batter is like $10. I feel like you should play this card, but I wouldn't play it unless you're on a heavier Bestial package. Otherwise, this card just doesn't come up. And it loses part of its effectiveness because you can't just link this card off or attribute it for Lebellion and then bring it back with Regained, which you can't do unless you're playing Lebellion or Regained. So it doesn't come up all the time. Chaos Angel, I don't even run this card, but this card is a fucking beast. I would put this probably towards the end of the priority list, but the card is really solid. I hope you guys enjoyed this overview of how I would play Budget Dragon Link. The deck will work. It should be fine. If you don't like 43 cards, cut some hand traps, cut Nocta the One, do whatever. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I hope to see you in the next one. Peace.